بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. In the name of Allah, most gracious, most merciful. Al-Jum'ah Magazine, your guide to an Islamic life. Volume 24, Issue 4, Rabi'u Thani, 1433 Hijri. E-Enlightenment. E-Enlightenment. The Global Online Revolution in Arabic and Islamic Studies by Zainab Khan. Eight Pathways to Arabic and Islamic Studies for the eager Arabic learner or the interested Islamic studies student living far away from Arab lands. The situation couldn't be better. A number of visionary and entrepreneurial Muslims, not a few of whom have been exactly in your situation, yearning to learn Islam and Arabic but needing access to a thoughtful and systematic faculty of teachers who are committed to Islam, knowledgeable in their subject areas, and possessed of a well-thought-out method for teaching serious adult students, have launched online Arabic and Islamic studies programs tailored to you. I researched eight of these from precisely this point of view. After a while, I currently reside in Egypt. I'm really one of you. These programs tend to fall into three categories in terms of the paradigm for education they seek to recreate online: traditional madrasa, online academy, and markaz or learning center model. In the first, I review only one institution, the Sharia program out of Canada. In the second comes Qibla in Amman, Jordan, Seekers Guidance in California, Arab Academy in Cairo, and Dalilusa based in Washington. Dalil USA based in Washington. Studio Arabia in Texas and Cairo, Medina Arabic in London and Cairo, and Alif Arabic out of Indiana are Category 3 programs. While for the most part they keep their prices competitive, the costs are wide ranging from under $80 a month to $2,000 for half a year. Services provided are also broad language immersion, trips abroad, intensive mini courses, classic lessons at a slower pace, tajweed training, an array of Islamic studies courses, and spiritual strengthening workshops. In terms of language, they teach everything from classical Arabic to business Arabic to colloquial Arabic by regional dialect. The companies differ also in their strengths and major focus. I approached the entire concept of online learning with a BDI, while further distrustful that Muslims would take the teaching of Arabic, Quran, and Islamic studies serious enough to make it a quality or worthwhile experience. I approached the entire concept of online learning with a BDI, while further distrustful that Muslims would take the teaching of Arabic, Quran, and Islamic studies serious enough to make it a quality or worthwhile experience. 2 months, 6 free trials, 2 demonstration sessions, and hours of interviews with the management teams later, my results yielded a far more complex and fascinating picture of what is available online and who is behind the growing movement. What follows is a brief look at each company, its background story, its purpose and mission, its development into what it is today, how transparent they are about their finances, and who and what is at the heart and soul of these organizations. I give an outline of the programs themselves and assess their strengths and weaknesses, unique offerings, teacher qualifications, quality of online environments, teaching approach and text, user feedback, user guarantees regarding dropping courses and refunds, and of course cost comparisons. 1. Traditional Madrasa Model, the Sharia program. Sheikh Yusuf Moulan studied in Flintham, Nottinghamshire in the United Kingdom as a young boy. The Badrul Umm in Rahmia Khan, Pakistan, as a young man, and then Darul Uloom in Karachi. He conceived the idea of the Sharia program in 2001 after graduating with a master's in Islamic theology from Darul Uloom, working at the masjid in Toronto as an imam. He very soon realized it wasn't his thing, as he put it. I would be teaching the kids, leading the prayer and preparing the khutbahs, and I found it important, but it wasn't where my strength was. So I got 4 students that were slightly older than me and taught them in my basement for a year. In that year, they went through 16 Arabic texts. The students, as he said, were older and more mature, and their study habits were developed. All factors he took note of. That observation was important because it took him back to his own days in the madrasa. He remembered watching people here or there, similar to the ones who approached him in Toronto, who had asked him to teach them Arabic. They were older and had college degrees. They were serious students who found themselves, after entering Islamic schools abroad, placed in low-level classes. This is a story that I myself found familiar. No doubt it rings with recognition for many students who have gone abroad in search of an education in Arabic and Islam, and for others unable to leave home, having neither progress in their personal pursuit of Arabic and Islamic studies, nor able to find a suitable program that would take them to the next level in their search to become more learned Muslims with the tools to acquire knowledge on their own. It is this person, like the majority of us who take our religion seriously, who Sheikh Yusuf recognized, having seen our lights in his own madrasa days. You have a serious person willing to move quickly. Their learning style is different, but they are stuck in classes where the teacher is catering to the lowest common denominator. Those students would get frustrated and drop off. From that day, when I observed this in the Toronto Masjid, I made the intention that I needed to come up with a method where I would make this accessible to those who are working professionals, university graduates, and people that realistically cannot enroll in a madrasa. For the last 10 years, every single day, I have been doing exactly that. The program, Sheikh Yusuf's intention was to do all 12 Islamic sciences in his program, including fiqh, hadith, tafsir, and so on. And that's where the name of the program comes from. He soon realized that it wouldn't work. You just can't keep people's attention and commitment for that long. The Sharia program today, and for many years now, focuses solely on teaching Arabic to the non-native speaker. While a 6-month face-to-face intensive course is offered, the bulk of students enroll in the 2-year online program. Twice a year, in late March and early October, new students are allowed to enroll. Books are shipped to the students and live classes are offered for an hour every Wednesday and Saturday through a free online program called Pal Talk. Some students choose to do their first semester over and over. Others drop out after the first year. Only a few continue to finish the entire 2-year program. The point of the course is to allow maximum flexibility so that students can access 55 hours of pre-recorded Arabic lessons even after they have finished the course. But in order to benefit fully from the online live sessions, students must keep pace with the rhythm of the real-time conferences, which are pegged to certain days of the week. Saturday is reserved for what he calls the cover theory, which means the teacher goes over the analytical aspects of the language and questions and answers ensue. Wednesday, students practice the vocabulary table. There are drawbacks about teaching language online, according to Sheikh Yusuf, such as doing vocabulary drills. Face-to-face, I can get all the students to participate. In the online classes, 50% choose to remain passive. The Wednesday session is an oral drill where we go through the verbal table recitation. The whole hour is devoted to having students recite the table from memory. The verb table gets high importance. There are three distinctive features of Sheikh Yusuf's online curriculum which features him as the Sharia program sole teacher. The first is a classical approach to studying Arabic. He doesn't use the typical text to teach Arabic to non-Arabs. Kitab al-Asasi, Bayna Yadayk, or the once celebrated elementary modern standard Arabic out of Ann Arbor. Rather, he begins with an analytical approach into Arabic, dissecting the way the language expresses meaning by scrutinizing and morphing root words and vowels to show the way Arabic functions. He claims this works so well. It takes the skilled student only 3 weeks to begin reading the stories of the prophets in Arabic. Sheikh Yusuf holds that this method of teaching how the language works and giving students the entire big picture up front accelerates progress by 1,600%. Yes, he has an equation and has them reading books by Al-Ghazali and Ibn Taymiyyah, while other beginners are still studying pronouns. By the 7th month, students begin Hidayah Nahu, a classical book on grammar, 132 pages long, without diacritic vocalization. In addition, the Sharia program has created a feedback loop where students tell Sheikh Yusuf what he needs to change the curriculum and how to tweak it. The program is kept alive and fresh, he says, by producing the material from time to time, which is challenging but necessary. Every so often, I scratch everything and redo the entire curriculum using our student feedback. This January, I began doing exactly that. While only Arabic classes are taught at the Sharia program, the student transitions to text and Islamic sciences as he or she develops sufficient language skills and vocabulary. By the second year, students analyze and break down verses of the Quran so that by the end of the 2 years, they have linguistically mapped out 2.5 ajza of the Quran. By that time, Sheikh Yusuf believes the student can stand behind the Imam in Tarawih prayers, for example, and understand much of the Arabic of the Quran. If you want to see what it's like before you seriously consider joining, you can first view the 3-alphabet tutorial. And for more advanced students, a 2-hour teaching seminar runs through the teaching concepts and methods of the program. Courses are pricey, however. If you enroll early, a year is $1,000, everything included. But there is the deal: after 3 months of trying out the course, if you decide it's not right for you, Sharia program will grant you a full refund. No questions asked and no fine print. No forms to fill out either. And frankly, that's amazing by any standard. Sheikh Yusuf's purpose in creating this online course is to enable students to understand the Quran and Sunnah. He wants people to become impacted by the miracle of the language of the Quran and not have to rely on translated Islamic texts to have access to the heritage of the scholars. This is what motivates us and dictates how we teach. Conversational fluency is one of our goals, but let me tell you, it's not our primary goal. I've been doing this for 10 plus years. This is all I do every day. I've taught that grammar book 19 times. Every time I teach it, I learn something new and it benefits me more. One would expect that there is very little difference at the 18th time. One would probably expect to deteriorate the level of enthusiasm and the level of teaching. In my case, that's not what happens. Every time I teach the book, I get energetic. The tone of my voice changes, and the students notice this change from me, and they really love that intensity. So if you are able to teach a book repeatedly, successfully, and happily, that means you have a strength. I took issue with the teaching style of the Sharia program, feeling it was analytical, too early in the normal progression of learning Arabic, but their student feedback perhaps provides better insight. 8 years into the program, less than 2% of students have asked for a full refund. Two, the online academies. Qibla began its teaching life as Witness Pioneer in the 90s under the auspices of Imran Chowdhury, Sheikh Faraz Rabbani, Abdullah Tortan, Huma Shah, and Ismail Ramadan. In 1998, the organization began to offer Islamic courses online. 5 years later, that witness pioneer phased out and became a library of sources, and the five founders rejoined to officially launch Sunni Path in 2003. A year later, courses on Fiqh, Imam Azali's famous Tahya books, Essential of Islam, Islamic Belief, and Islamic Spirituality were offered. By 2006, Sunni Path began offering Arabic courses. 2 years later, they received accreditation from WISE, WISE, World Islamic Sciences and Education University, an Islamic university based in Jordan, consisting of the College of Usul al-Din and College of Islamic Arts, which grew out of the College of Usul al-Din at Al-Balqa Applied University, which is the largest university in Jordan. In 2011, the management team changed their name from Sunni Path to Qibla. Qibla follows the Quranic principle, ask those who know in managing this organization, says Imran Chowdhury. We have people in different areas with different expertise. We have scholars who are well qualified to teach, as well as managers that are doing a wonderful job in their respective areas. Qibla also has a Sharia advisory board who we seek advice from on Sharia matters. Our curriculum and classes are designed and developed by our teachers. Three of Qibla's founding five provided the initial funding to begin the online academy, but today's student tuition and small private donations sustain the organization. If Qibla falls short of funds a certain year, some of the founders contribute out of pocket to make up the deficit. Qibla is truly a well-established distance learning institution. They divide their year beginning after Ramadan and ending before the start of the following Ramadan into two semesters with global winter intensive courses during the typical weeks of winter break for universities. And those more than 16,000 students are currently enrolled at Qibla. They select from 152 courses. An open forum provide Muslims opportunity to ask Qibla teachers questions regarding issues pertaining to personal or religious life. According to Chowdhury, Qibla trains and maintains an academic advising team, a financial aid committee, and a managerial staff that works to develop and perfect its track of study. Currently, Qibla offers prospective students not only the ability to take classes at large, i.e. any class they desire from the Islamic sciences, Quran, or Arabic levels, but they have also organized their courses into programs of study. Certificate track offerings. 1. Foundation Diploma. The purpose of this track is to give Muslims the essentials of Islamic knowledge. B. It empowers those who have completed the foundation of diploma to teach at weekend Islamic schools and halaqahs. C. Almost all courses filed under the Foundation Diploma are eligible for financial aid. 2. Miftah Diploma. This diploma is the stepping stone to the seekers. Seekers and inheritors pro Sibawa Sibawa and inheritors programs. B. It's primarily a track to develop Arabic textual fluency and expertise so students can access classical Islamic books. The teaching curriculum is similar to the previously described Sharia program. They offer a classical approach to studying grammar, morphology, and rhetoric. 3. Seekers Diploma. The Seekers Certificate builds itself as providing the students with solid and comprehensive knowledge of the core Islamic audiences. B. It aims to enable students to answer critiques about the authenticity of the Quran and Sunnah. 4. Sibawiya Degree. This degree takes students wanting to master the Arabic language to the highest Sibawiya Degree. This degree takes students wanting to master the Arabic language to the highest level of Qibla offers. B. Students read classical primers on the rules of Arabic. 5. Inheritors degree, planned but not yet offered. Classes in this track mirror a classical Islamic education path. books are read and discussed fully and are neither simplified, translated, nor edited. Courses run for as long as students need to finish and master the material. The inheritor's degree seeks to mimic as closely as possible a serious scholarly program of study, though online. Associate's degree, upon completion of this track of study, regular grant students an accredited by WISE University, an accredited associate's degree, though one cannot use previous or concurrent college courses to augment this. B, students may be content to finish after obtaining this degree or use it towards the completion of a bachelor's degree wherever WISE University degrees are recognized. C, the associate's degree requirements are rigorous. A student must complete 69 courses, 57 of which are core requirements and 12 of which are elective courses. 7, Tajweed certificate. 3 courses comprise this track. It teaches students the rulers of the Tajweed and enables them to recite the Quran in a broken chain of transmission leading back to the Prophet ﷺ, so that he or she is appropriately trained to recite the Quran the way the Prophet ﷺ did. Reviewers' findings. My experience with Qibla left the best impression on me of all the programs I reviewed online. The quality of the teaching, teacher expertise, professionalism, yet attention to dealing with students on a personal level, the Arabic curriculum, teaching software, and organization of the online courses all were top flight. This is not my experience alone. Qibla has the highest positive user feedback of any of the learning institutions I searched. Almost all of their teachers have relocated to Amman upon the request of the management team at Qibla. They present their pre-recorded and live sessions from a teaching studio specifically chosen to provide the most formal yet comfortable learning environment. Weekly students complete lessons, view pre-recorded lessons with the teacher on video and with accompanying slides. If a student desires, there is an electronic notebook they can record their own notes with. Live sessions are also recorded and made available to the student 1 year after enrollment. Qibla's whiteboards are the best on the market. The computer diagramming of Arabic sentences is a unique innovation of the Qibla staff, primarily the work of Sheikh Hamza Ali. Sound and video quality are excellent, and I found the curriculum sophisticated yet clear and uncomplicated. Teachers are chosen not only for their grasp of the content and skills in the areas they are teaching, but also based on character references and integrity. Moral fiber is important to us because Islamic sciences are not merely academic disciplines, says Chowdhury. They are tools to take people to Allah Most High. Students who choose to take a course with Qibla sign up. Academic advising is available for free. Sign up and access all class materials online. They work through their lessons, take exams, and attend live sessions with the teacher, but also have the option of connecting with the professors and classmates on a class forum message board. In the Qibla program, it will likely take a student 2 years to understand the Quran when the Imam is reciting during Tarawih prayer. Qibla tuition rates are the highest of all learning institutions I reviewed. Taking a regular course at large is $225. But Arabic courses, due to the intensity of student-teacher interaction, is $375. The lower level of track of study is $1,200, but with the scholarships that Qibla generally offers, this sum will come down from a third to a half. Students can pay in 1, 2, or 3 installments. Full refunds are granted only up to 2 weeks after the start of the semester. A 50% refund is available after 4 weeks. Therefore, there are no refunds. Qibla offers graded tuition rates based on country of residence, income, and personal circumstances. Financial aid is available for those in need. Seekers Guidance. Seekers Guidance is a nascent yet fast-growing online learning academy, having called on private donations to cover a startup post. Its founder, Sheikh Fariz Rabbani, is author of Absolute Essentials of Islam, Faith, Prayer, the Path of Salvation according to the Hanafi School. You may remember his name as one of the original organizers of Qibla. Sheikh Faraz studied abroad in Damascus and Amman for 10 years. While there is overlap between Qibla and Seeker's Guidance, some of their courses and their features are extremely similar. The latter institution is geared toward intellectual activism. Seeker's Guidance has a four-pronged approach to its program. They actively attempt to link scholars and students on the path to scholarship and other Muslims by creating a dynamic online learning environment. The online academy, Seeker's Guidance, began offering online courses 3 years ago, and this year has made all its course fee answer services. Their free answer service provides scholars affiliated with them to answer questions of personal concern. One may also search for relevant answers in their archives. They say their scholars answer about 5,000 questions per year, or about 10 to 20 a year. All answers are checked and approved by Sheikh Faraz Rabbani. Webinars and seminars. Seeker's Guidance encourages groups to invite teachers and hold weekend seminars. 2 years ago, they held 40 across the globe. What they call Live Seeker's Webinars offer free interactive presentations on key facts of Islamic faith and practice. Blog and Islamcasts. Seekers, scholars, and teachers upload a podcast to help Muslims deal practically with life in the 21st century based on the Quran and Sunnah. The Seekers blog also carries articles from names well known to Muslims who read about Islamic topics and perspectives online in English. Seekers Guidance divides its academic year trimesters, August, November, January, March, April, July, typically 400-600 students enrolled per semester. Since the launching at the beginning of this year of their tuition-free Knowledge Without Barriers initiative, the enrollment has grown to tenfold to 4,000. Its actual Arabic courses are limited, however, they offer only introduction to Arabic grammar. The management team hires instructors who have studied in the Muslim world and tries to ensure that all teachers have ijazat or traditional authorizations for the courses they teach through sound chains of transmission. Seeker's Guidance has a catalog of more than 25 courses in the areas of spirituality, Quran, Arabic, Islamic law, and time management. Perhaps the most unique course offering is the Shatibi certificate in the 7th Quranic stations. Here is what their literature has to say about it. Students learn the evolution of the science of the Qira'at and the rules pertaining to reciting the Quran according to the 7 most prevalent methods of recitation. Upon successful completion of this 4-part series, the students will receive the Shatibi certificate of completion in 10 Qira'at. Those whom the instructor feels have demonstrated sufficient mastery will receive the Shatibi certificate for instruction, ijazat, in this sacred science. Seeker's Guidance posts their curriculum, detailed course outlines and notes online. Each class has downloadable MP3 files, questions at the end of each lesson, around the clock, access to instructors through student forums, and live sessions scattered throughout the course. The institution endeavors to follow a classical approach to the Islamic sciences and can be best compared to something akin to Qibla. However, the quality of experience in terms of their online environment, the quality of their teachers, many have studied abroad but lack formalized credentials, their curriculum and their online software doesn't compare to Qibla. Seeker's Guidance single introductory Arabic class significantly limits a prospective student's ability to choose a level appropriate to him or her. Moreover, it precludes continued long-term study with the program. While Seeker's Guidance should be recognized as a leader for its endeavor to make Islamic learning free, truly modeling traditional learning, it is more akin to an online study group with a perspective than a full program of Arabic or Islamic studies. Arabic Academy. Arab Academy. Arab Academy is the personal investment and innovation of Sana Ghanem, an Arabic teacher for more than 20 years. After obtaining a postgraduate degree in teaching Arabic as a foreign language, TAFL, she did just that at the American University in Cairo, AUC, to students enrolled in the CASA program in the 1980s, when CASA was one of the premier programs for Arabic studies catering to Western University students. Ghanem spent the next 10 years teaching Arabic both at the University of Abidjan, at Cote d'Ivoire, and later again at AUC. Her software program Learn Arabic won the best educational program in the Middle East in 1996 at the CITICS Fair in Dubai. She crafted the entire online program that is currently Arab Academy's curriculum herself, bearing all the startup costs. I would not advise investors to enter the business, this business, says Ghanem. Anyone interested in it has to be motivated by the desire to promote Arabic. If you make money, that is well and good, but if you don't, you have to be satisfied by what you have done to attain your objective, or at least contribute to it in any small way. Arab Academy can best be described as a self-taught course organized and fully available online. Students enroll in their Arabic appropriate level and then go through and as many levels as the Academy provides, which is from zero level to advanced Arabic. Each level has 4 units with 7 lessons, a total of 28 lessons per level. At the end of each unit, there is an exam and writing assignment with an online Arabic keyboard provided as a feature of the software. The course structure will be familiar to anyone who has studied a foreign language in America. Each unit includes stories with pre-recorded voiceovers with accompanying computerized images and text, drills, and a list of vocabulary words. Arab Academy students move through each level at their own pace, and if desired, use Arab Academy's booking system to reserve weekly or twice a week lessons with a live teacher from Egypt. The teachers are all graduates in the fields they teach, Arabic or Quran from the University of Cairo or Al-Azhar University, who then attend an in-house teacher training seminar. There are 3 course options to choose from. The classic plan, 1 month subscription, no live teacher, $99 a month, the cost. The fast plan, 3 month subscription, live teacher once a week, $79 a month. The fastest plan, 6 month subscription, live teacher twice a week, 1 week free immersion in Cairo at the on-site Arab Academy Tutoring Center, $59 a month. Arab Academy offers an array of classes in the tradition of early programs designed for Western students, modern standard Arabic, Quranic Arabic, Egyptian colloquial, Egypt's Arabic curriculum, i.e. the Arabic curriculum taught in Egypt schools from first grade to the end of high school, graded stories, and tajweed. The Academy also has teaching contracts with 9 public schools in the United States, making Arabic a viable option of study for high school students. How does it work? Students enter the computer lab and go through the assigned levels once or two or twice each week, or not at all, depending on the plan. The facilitator connects a teacher from Egypt in real time on Skype, and students then interact with a live teacher. Astonishingly, Arab Academy boasts not hundreds but tens of thousands of students. More than 24,000 student IDs and passwords were registered at the time of my interview. The Academy draws well from the non-Muslim public. These include individuals interested in learning basic or intermediate Arabic, others who will be residing for a time in an Arab country, young students who have Arab friends and want to learn some Arabic, and students who have a mildly serious interest in the language. Arab Academy is akin to buying a self-teaching language course from a bookstore with an accompanying DVD, but as we are all seeing a movement away from hard copy books to electronic source materials has made it especially convenient for interested students to opt for an online course instead. In this case, for most prospective distance learning students, not only is everything neatly and conveniently available at the click of a mouse, the companion native teacher is. This academy is a good program if you fit into one of these categories or want similar results. It will not satisfy the palate of those interested in a serious and profound study of Arabic and the intangibles of traditional learning engagement. Dalil USA is a one-man band, says founder Professor Waleed Farhood. Though he works closely with specialized graphic designers, programmers, and business managers to maintain his company, Professor Farhood has a postgraduate degree in Middle East languages and culture. He taught Arabic for many years at the University of Washington and Seattle University. Like many of the others, he not only started Dalil USA, he financed its first year. Therefore, the company was able to sustain itself because it is designed to concurrently provide a directory of Middle Eastern commercial services as well as a linguistic liaison between consumers and businesses, translating services, proofreading, etc. Students can download courses any time of the year. The process begins by browsing through the listing of courses online. Colloquial Arabic, Lebanese and North African dialect, Classical Arabic and Quranic Arabic, with full descriptions of the curriculum as well as sample lessons. Each course consists of 36 lessons, 36 drills, and meant to be completed in 36 weeks. Classical Arabic courses are $480 for 40 weeks, and colloquial courses are half that amount. Tuition is paid in advance and no refund is available, which Farhood says is meant to discourage illegal downloads. Farhood believes that it would take about a year and a half study with his company to become semi-fluent and understand much of the Quran in Tarawih prayer. Dalil USA's constituency is mostly local. Its students hearken from American colleges and universities who need more support in learning Arabic. I appreciated Waleed's straightforward and frank manner, agreeing that distance learning is not the best way to study a language. In my reviews of the sample lessons, Dalil USA had a very unsophisticated curriculum and website and a crude online environment. Students interested in studying Arabic will find far between programs at much better prices elsewhere. 3. The Markaz Models. Meet Studio Arabia. Studio Arabia is one of the newest of the online Arabic teaching programs and the one with the most affordable rates of those that charge. Studio Arabia began as a small new business venture, but it has since captured or turned into a sincere and innovative project of the Graf family. John and Stacy Graf grew up in Oklahoma and converted to Islam. John's desire to study Arabic and access classical Islamic texts took him to Cairo, Egypt, where he studied for a few years and then entered Al-Azhar University. At first, he partnered with the trained pupil of his Arabic teacher Muhammad Abdul Latif to help friends who wanted to do what John did, but without relocating to the Arab world. As demand for their services increased, the Grafs decided to start their own company. John not only designed the teacher training course mandatory for all instructors, he even constructed his very own novel curriculum for zero-level Arabic for children as well as adult learners, titled The Fast Track to Learning Arabic. In this book, Graf relies on phonics, best strategy to teach reading. To teach reading, students learn the sounds of the letter of the Arabic alphabet before they learn the names of the letters. In just a few short lessons, although students have not been exposed to all of the letters, they are able to read. I'm very convinced from what I've seen that approaching reading Arabic through phonics is faster and more effective, says John. You learn to pronounce the letters first, begin reading, and then you learn the names of the letters. The biggest problem I've seen people face in learning Arabic is that the process of learning reading is inverse. The new student learns the names of new letters, then he has to go back and learn to pronounce them, and then learn to pronounce them with vowels. Frustration from the length of time it takes to start reading and confusion discerning the sounds of alike sounding letters leads to demotivation. The way I've written my book within just a few short lessons, the new student has learned the pronunciation of the first half of the alphabet with the three short vowels and is reading. At least 90% of the vocabulary words in Graf's book come from the Quran's lexicon, and fully he culled from Juz' Amma. Graf carefully handpicked these vocabulary words, searching for those that are most likely to be seen or used by modern speakers or writers. It is with this same spirit, quality, yet personal attention to detail that Studio Arabia continues to develop its online program. One of the many advantages it provides is that its founder has had intimate experience starting off as a non-native speaker who then spent many years trying to become as proficient as one, specifically focusing on reading Islamic texts and developing strong writing skills. Though Medina Arabic, which we will meet next, inshallah, and Studio Arabia are very comparable, Graf brings the heart of a long-time student of Arabic and Quran to his institution. I believe that our approach from the start has been less a business of teaching Arabic and more a mission to bring the best of knowledge, the Quran and its understanding, Arabic, to people. Since the value and importance of Arabic is because of the Quran, to specialize in only teaching Arabic is losing sight of its real purpose and neglects an overall program. This is why we not only offer Tajweed and Quran memorization, but we specialize in it just as we specialize in teaching Arabic. Prospective students sign up for a free trial, then arrange for the course time and date. If they choose to continue a course materials, either Kitab Al-Asasi or Bayna Yadayk are mailed to them. According to Graf, it would take a committed student a year and a half to stand in Tarawih prayer and understand the verses of Quran that are being recited. My experience with the free trial in Arabic and Quran showed me that the Quran course was surprisingly strong. The teacher was well skilled and could discern the right and wrong sounds I was making. I composed it to a life experience I had with the I had with her to make my evaluation accurate, and conducted herself with professionalism and meticulousness. Though the Arabic classes need development, teaching software such as with whiteboard, breaking down contents, offering spontaneous skills to solidify those concepts, and assessment of student comparison were still being worked out. Studios Arabia's evaluation system makes for a fast and efficient transition into serious studies. Studio Arabia's use of Skype lent a casual feel to class time, both from my end and the teachers, Studio Arabia's use of Skype lent a casual feel to class time, both from my end and the teachers, which I consider a drawback. However, the management team is continuously working to improve their programming and to incorporate user feedback to enhance the student experience. Customer service is excellent, positive user feedback is high, and it has one of the easiest navigable and aesthetic websites on the market. All courses are designed to provide one-on-one time between teacher and student for a flat fee, $79 a month, which is hands down the best fee among all the paying programs with qualified teachers and continuously developing and improving curriculum. A review of Medina Arabic. Rahil Hanan, a law graduate from the United Kingdom and performance analyst for SAP, a leading business management software company, designed a free website, MedinaArabic.com, with Sheikh Suleiman Ghani, a graduate of Medina University and a graduate from Cairo University. Hunan fronted the startup and development course for both institutions. Medina Arabic was designed 8 years ago to offer free online Arabic lessons to everyone who could access their website. The company marks or markets heavily to interested individuals in the United Kingdom and the United States. In order to continue the development and sustainability of the free website, Hannah knew he and his management team had to have a for-profit company that could invest surplus funds into the non-profit organization. They also knew they create a visible and thriving company. They also knew there was a large market of eager Arabic and students to create a viable and thriving company. The British team partners with on-site Egyptian teachers and managers to create an affordable Arabic afford similar learning options and experiences to Studio Arabia charge. They use Kitab al-Asasi and Bain Arabic, but have customized aspects of their curriculum. In Medina's Arabic case, they have personally designed their spoken business Arabic courses. Interested students sign up for a free demonstration setup a time and meet with their teacher. All courses materials are available online. Medina Arabic strives to provide private, flexible, inexpensive Quran and Arabic courses using Skype. As a positive student feedback is high for Medina Arabic, and customer service is prompt, courteous, and helpful. A course with this online company costs $12 per hour or $144 a month. Requests for refunds have never been denied since the company opened its doors for business a year ago. Hanan believes it would take a student a little less than a year and half with his tutoring service to be able to understand the Quran during a Taraweeh prayer. Medina Arabic's Quran class was just as strong as Studio Arabia's, but their Arabic teaching was stronger because the teacher seemed more experienced. The whiteboard software used in to teach students was rudimentary, however, resembling the basic paint program that comes with all PCs. It's hard to manipulate the electronic pencil. There is a delay between when the teacher writes on the board and when it appears on the student's screen, and the writing board is very small. Rahil Hanan brings the commitment of an analyst to Medina Arabic. He crunches numbers and analyzes figures continuously to improve the business. His real mission, he says, is to make the learning of Arabic and the Quran accessible to people all over the world who cannot travel abroad. Alif Arabic, director and CEO Omar Atiyah, founded the for-profit company Alif Arabic less than 2 years ago and is no stranger to Muslim non-profit organization management. He was behind the establishment of Elevate Foundation, Bridge, and Jannah Foundation, raising funds from Muslims through all of the instructions mentioned above to start his company. Alif Arabic partners with the managerial team and teaching staff in Egypt using Kitab al-Asasi and Bain Yadayk to tutor students one-on-one through Skype. Alif Arabic's customer support and flexibility with student schedule is excellent. The actual learning experience, however, is the poorest quality of the three Marrakesh modules. Indeed, all of the eight companies I reviewed, three sessions into our free trial over Skype, repeated explanations that I already had 3 years of University Arabic Learning under my belt, and 3 more years living abroad in Cairo. My Quran and Arabic teacher, who was steadfastly testing me on the room and sign letters, basic reading concept. There was no evaluation at the start of the trial. The tutor, though friendly and forthcoming, conducted herself informally and rarely used any teaching tools throughout the sessions. Moreover, in my interview with the director, I found discrepancies with his answers and the actual features of Aleph Arabic. For example, he reported that all of his Quran teachers have ijazat in tajweed and memorization. I asked my teacher at the start of our first tajweed lesson if she had an ijaz, and she replied in the negative. Upon further research, I learned that many of their teachers do not hold ijaz. Online learning in the context of history. Hundreds of teachers from the West have traveled abroad in the past decade to learn Arabic and Islam, and now teach at these online institutions to the thousands of students now enrolled in their classes. The vibrancy of the internet online learning atmosphere reflects the vigor animating the growing study of Islam in the Muslim world and the West. Contrary to popular belief, the Islamic sciences do not comprise a deep field today. It is very much alive and teeming. John Vole, professor of Islamic studies at Georgetown University, wrote an essay published in the Journal of World History titled Islam as Special World System. In it, he argues that Darul Islam, this global unit that stretched from the areas of East Asia to modern-day Europe and as far south as sub-Saharan Africa, allowed one to feel encompassed in the House of Islam because it was built on a series of exchanges, not material but spiritual, of thought, ideas, and scholarships. There were particular agents of this dissemination who were eager to travel from place to place seeking out renowned scholars and listening to their opinions on matters of fiqh, theology, and spirituality. Whenever they sojourned at a particular locale, they would be sure to impart the opinions, beliefs, concerns, and ideas of all the other places they came from, visiting and studying in them. This created a feedback loop such that a person from Morocco who visited China and witnessed Muslims praying there in a different but valid way still felt that he was in Dar es Salaam, a place that was familiar, known, and recognizable. Teachers and disciples journeyed from end to end of the Muslim world, he writes, bearing the seeds of interchange and cross-fertilization. Interestingly, the two most developed and sophisticated programs featured in this article, Qibla and Seeker's Guidance, have distinctive origins similar to the groups Vol is speaking of. My questions are two. Has distance education, particularly online schooling, taking the place of hundreds of years of characteristic study travels of students in Muslim and non-Muslim lands to seek out knowledge all over the globe? And if so, how will this shift impact Darul Islam? To answer the second question first, if individuals and families cease to travel to the Muslim world or even within the Muslim world for the sake of seeking knowledge, that special world system that Vol so accurately describes as characteristic of Islam would certainly vanish. The fact is that this phenomenon of Talab al-Ilm, questing after knowledge, has played a great role in energizing and keeping alive the Muslim Ummah, curbing modern society's desecrating tendency toward inwardness and isolation, or descending tendency toward inwardness and isolation, looking down on one another and dehumanizing the other because we cannot understand his hopes, dreams, and concerns. Today, the pursuit of Islamic knowledge on behalf of Westerners leads the affluent and the less so to adopt, even if for a time, a more humble existence and to venture out of Western dogma and into a discourse that centers around the word of Allah, the Prophet, Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, his companions, and the scholars who followed them. It forces them to look upon the faces and the characters of those who have lived a life devoted to memorizing and translating the Quran, learning about the Prophet and perfecting their character. These modern day seekers, after light coming out of the lands where the sun sets, learn habits, manners, and values that can only be imbibed through seeing them enacted in a real person in real time and in a concrete context. Moreover, this experience is bi-directional. Westerners carry with them and transmit their own strengths, ideas, thoughts, and discourse, striking an important balance in the discussion. Living in Cairo and having some exposure to the foreigners that come from the West to study in Muslim land, I can say that online schooling has not yet discouraged or inadvertently put a halt to the serious study and travel of eager students. However, mass production and consumption of education, particularly on the World Wide Web, must be cautioned for another reason. Still, that I think I sense such a venue can create homogeneity, voices can become unvaried, and opinions in danger of becoming uniform. This has been the flattening juggernaut trend of globalization, and the biggest culprit of this phenomenon is arguably the internet. And the future, when one looks at the numbers, it's clear that Arabic and Islamic studies online and institutions are not yet capturing the smaller but significant number of students who actualize their desire to go abroad and seek knowledge, that total reportedly being well over 40,000. But what the rising number of online learners of Islam and Arabic most probably mean is that there is a huge and broader need among Muslims from the West, because that is who these programs are marketed to, primarily among English speakers for basic as well as advanced practicable academic access to Arabic, Quran, and the Sunnah. The real question then may be that if there is such a need, why have we not created real physical institutions of learning? Or perhaps I should say that through teeming centers of learning and enough of them. I'm not saying that distance learning should be done away with. Rather, I'm cautious about our becoming too comfortable with the notion that online learning is sufficient even to fulfill the need that is being expressed by the large numbers of Muslims who have designed or have signed up with these organizations. There is something inexplicably valuable about holding a book, sitting with a teacher, discussing with one's peers face to face, and something even more indispensable in the movement of people, ideas, and thoughts in the circulation of worldly discourse. My true fear is that the online environments can give the illusion that cyberspace is physically space, and that the value of Islamic of dynamism, acknowledgement, knowledge, of dynamic atmosphere of learning is steadily being eroded, so that we will no longer invest the time, money, and energy needed to create those physical spaces. My own feelings oscillate between this line. Having said this, I confess that my sympathies lie wholeheartedly with young girls and women who cannot easily travel and study abroad. The ability to study with native Arabic speakers at an affordable rate and from the ease and privacy of your home supplies the willing but stationary student a truly golden opportunity. Alhamdulillah.